Welcome back to Skylanders Giants for 3DS. Next up is the Pirate Seas Adventure Pack. Actually, I should probably summon that first. Alrighty, so there is Pirate Seas. I'm gonna check on the elements here and then I'll switch in some Skylanders to fit that. Okay, so the first level, Windjammer Bay, which has two hats. We have Earth and Tech, and the second one has just Earth. Alrighty, well, let's see. I think I have some Skylanders in mind. Okay, so I have Boomer and Prism Break. And Boomer has a hat that I put on him a while ago, but I think it fits him. And Prism Break, this is Series 2 Prism Break. I actually haven't used him yet, as you can see. But I think he should be fine regardless. Alright, the first level of Pirate Seas here is Windjammer Bay, and then we have Pontoon Point. Alrighty, there was an objective that said Lead Mutiny. I don't remember what you're supposed to do there, but we're going to find out soon. And that... the challenge level of Pirate Seas is actually pretty difficult. It's not as difficult as the Empire of Ice one, but I think it'll take a few tries. Ah, yes, I remember this one now. Okay, we have those rocket barrels. Just watch out for those. Ah, this music is really catchy. Okay, I want to level him up a little bit. I have Prism Break, Series 1 Prism Break, and then the Light Core one, and those are the ones I've been using. I actually just got the Series 2 one recently, so he hasn't leveled up much. And then Boomer, I've leveled up a lot because I used him quite a bit in Skylanders as far as Adventure. Okay, so his primary attack, he throws dynamite, and his secondary attack, the ground pound. You can hold it in to do more damage too. It propels him in the air. It's actually pretty awesome. Oh. This guy's like pretty dangerous. I got him. And Prism Break, his main attack is the laser beam from his crystals, and the secondary attack, he summons a series of crystals, then he can aim at those and spread the laser. Okay, Chompies. Okay, so we need 8 Chompies to defeat. I'm just trying to collect all the stuff here before I move on. Oh, okay. And Lead Mutiny, that's the one I wasn't sure about what that means. Alright, but to get off this part, we just have to go through the teleport pad. Actually took quite a bit of damage already. It's all because of that big blue ogre thing. And running into dynamite like that. Alright, so one of Boomer's upgrades, as he walks around, or runs around, excuse me, he just drops bombs in his place. Really useful. You know, when I first started playing Skylanders, I really did not like Boomer, and like I kind of avoided buying his, you know, his figure. But then I eventually decided to buy all of them, and so I kind of had to buy his. And I started using him. I'm like, wow, he's actually really cool. He's actually one of my favorite tech ones from the first game. He's just, his power is like really immense. Like, on here, it's not really representative of what he can do, but on the console one, yeah, he is like a monster. Yeah, it turns out he's actually like, in terms of just like the regular figures, non-variants, oops, that's my fault. He's actually one of the rarest ones, if not the rarest one. Actually, a friend of mine, Jason, the one who made the intro to Giants video, or these videos, I should say, the whole series. Awesome intro, by the way. He needed Boomer. He was like one of the last ones to complete his collection. And that's pretty much when I found out just how rare he was. I was like, oh, maybe I can try to find him. Like, I managed to find him in the triple pack, but he already had the other two in the triple pack that Boomer's in, which I think is... I know Prism Break is one. Can't remember the other one in that triple pack. But regardless, he had both of them already. So I can really help him out there. I should say the Boomer in single pack is pretty rare now. And as far as I know, they're not making the Series 1 toys anymore, so if you need some of the rare ones, you should probably get them sooner than later. Okay, but a lot of stores still sell the Series 1s, it's just, you know, most of them have clearanced them out or gotten rid of them. So, kind of unfortunate, but I mean, the first game's been out since late 2011 already, so going on 2 years. And they're focusing on Giants, and then they just announced, oh shoot, a couple days ago, the new Skylanders game, the third one, Swap Force. So the Series 1s are going to be even more rare when that comes out. So again, if you need any Series 1s, you probably get them now before they, like, really hike in price. This is weird, though. Like, when the first game came out, Boomer was, like, so easy to find. Like, if you went to a store, the two Skylanders you're most likely to run into was Boomer and Wrecking Ball. And Wrecking Ball's still pretty common. I've seen him quite a bit. The Series 1 Wrecking Ball, but Boomer is pretty rare, so... Yeah, it's funny how that turned out. Oh, that's what that is? The lead mutiny? You're getting rid of the rear admirals? I wonder why they changed the text. But anyway, these guys are really, really strong, so I'm trying to avoid the... Oh, he got Boomer. I have to revive him, though. I can't do this as Prison Break. He's barely even leveled up. That was an accident. I did not mean to switch to him. I really didn't... Well, I guess it still counts as getting the 100 because I met that goal, so... What was the other objective? Snow Chompies and Lead Mutiny. Okay. Alright, so I'm not going to miss anything around here because I think I've run into all the Chompies and Rear Admirals that are in this part. I'm actually almost done with these objectives then. Except the Elemental Challenge. I haven't seen the tech one yet. If you notice, I don't really put hats on my Skylanders. Some of them just look weird. I mean, some of them fit, like this one on Boomer. It actually fits him really well. And I have the general hat on Trigger Happy, but I generally don't like using them. Well, not that I don't like them, I just don't prefer to use them. Oops. I mean, on here, they don't enhance anything, but on the console version, they actually... certain hats give you pretty big boosts in stats. So, but I've never had like a point in the game where I like really needed a boost in a certain attribute, but they do help. I just don't prefer using the hats much. And the thing is, like, if you want a certain boost in a certain area, like for speed, you need a specific hat for that because they all have different attributes, and the speed one might look dumb on a certain Skylander that you want to enhance their speed. So, sometimes I just don't bother. Okay. Probably wasn't a good idea to use Prison Break here because, he's strong, but I haven't upgraded him at all, so he's not living up to his potential. Alright, I actually just hit 100 again, so even if, like, reviving my Skylanders, like, counted against that 100 total that you need for this level, I'm back up to that amount, so... not a big deal. This level does give you a lot of coins, though, if you notice. Wow, he just knocked me right in the to the water. That was very annoying. Yeah, it's just really unfortunate. Like, I can't really do much with Prison Break right now. Like, to get stronger, he needs the upgrades, but in order to get the upgrades, he needs to defeat enemies, but he's weak right now. Oh, my battery's dying. Alright, sorry about that interruption, but wasn't plugged in, so that the 3DS was actually flashing like crazy, so it was actually about to die at any second. Just didn't even notice. Okay, I need to switch out. Alright, so that's all the rear admirals, and I think I'm just one chompy away from clearing this too. Oh no, I got all of them. Okay, I got everything. I just have to get to the end of the level then. See, one thing I don't like about Prison Break here is, well, right now, there's the exit. The crystal doesn't drop down. So it's not as strong. Like, on the console one, you drop down a crystal on their head, and it does a lot of damage. And then you just laser them to death. Here, you have to, like, it's not as potent. At least right now. Maybe it'll change when he gets upgraded. Alright, and here's the exit. Alright, now I just have to go back for the time challenge. And as you saw, that level actually isn't that bad. The objectives here were pretty easy. Especially compared to Empire of Ice. Okay, the general hat and the pirate hat. Pirate hat is pretty much a given for this one. It's pirate themed. Okay, I'm probably just gonna stick with these two for the time challenge. I don't really feel like switching them out. But for the next mission, yeah, I'll switch to different characters. Okay, so after we're done with this, we're gonna head to Darklight Crypt, and then after that, it's Dragon's Peak, and that's the end of the game. This game is pretty much all about, like, just doing missions and stuff like that. There aren't any extra challenges like heroic challenges or arena battles, mini games. Maybe for the third game. They did announce that Skylanders Swap Force, the third game in the series, is heading to 3DS as well. But I'm wondering how that's going to be, because in the console version they introduced jumping. Like, that was previously exclusive to the 3DS games. But since you can jump in the console one now, gotta wonder how this one's gonna be. The third one's gonna be on the 3DS. I mean, I'd imagine the engine's probably gonna be the same as this one, but which isn't, you know, all bad, but at the same time, it's, if you're expecting something different, you're probably gonna get more or less the same if they do end up going that that route. Okay, they don't really give you a lot of time here. It's just 2 minutes, a little over 2 minutes. I think maybe it started at 3, 2.5. I don't know. So I'm gonna try to blitz through here, just by defeating the enemies as fast as possible. I'm gonna try to get some of these bigger enemies because they might drop some stopwatches, like that one did. And it doesn't hurt to get like fruit and stuff like that too. Trying to get him leveled up to at least maybe level 4 or something. Oh, I can't reach up there. I have to go this way. There we go. If you look online, you can actually find some art of Boomer, like, before. Like, this is the final product, obviously, but before they settled on this design form, he actually looked, like, really mean. You have like a rounder nose too. This one's more pointed. There's actually some official art. It was actually very close to being in the final game, but I guess they wanted to make him look a little bit more friendly or goofy or something. Get that food basket. There we go. Alright, 2 clocks. Nice. I actually like Prison Break a lot too. Like, I bet once he gets upgraded, he's really good. Just right now, he's pretty mediocre. What I like is the design. And they actually, when they showed off the Light Core Skylanders, he was like one of the first ones that they showed. But it makes sense because his crystals glow. Whoa. They are bringing. Oh, crap, I'm gonna fall in, yep. They are bringing back Light Core Skylanders for the third game as well. There's gonna be 8 new ones. I just hope they actually do something, because in this game they didn't really do much, if at all. Like, if they do something, I've never noticed that they did anything. Yeah, I've used them quite a bit in the playthrough. Of certain ones. I'm pretty sure I've used at least every, like, one form of somebody, like... I know I didn't use the regular Pop Fizz, but I used the Punch one. And I don't think I used anyone except... because I have Series 1 Drobot, but I don't think I used him, I used Lycor. You know, stuff like that. One form of every Skylander in the playthrough. Except for Ninjini, who is still not out yet. Well, I shouldn't say she's not out yet, but she's not available to the public, because there was like an event a couple weeks ago where like the first 500 people that showed up, it was in New York, they would give out a Ninjini. And she's not supposed to be out until like another month or two. But yeah, she's not out yet. She's not available to the public yet, and I don't have her, so she's probably not going to show up in this playthrough at all, unfortunately. Okay, but that was the time challenge. That mission was pretty easy overall. The regular mission and the time challenge wasn't that bad. It's just there was like a couple of those hard-hitting enemies, those was the rear admirals or whatever. Ice ogres. Pretty much that ice forming move just takes out a big chunk of your Skylander's health if you get hit by it. Alrighty, so next level here, I'm not gonna do it now, that's gonna be in the next video, I just wanna see stuff about it. Okay, defeat 50 enemies, elemental match is earth. Avoid the water, which actually is pretty difficult, because if you look at the picture of it on the bottom right there, like, you're on these, like, rafts, and they dip down into the water, so basically you can't be on one when it dips down, or you can't fall in. So that's going to be pretty tough. And then don't eat food. That, again, is pretty tough because this whole challenge arena just takes place on those small rafts, so sometimes it's pretty easy to run into food. Okay. We'll get to that next time, though. Thanks for watching, everybody.